In 1896, 19-year-old Clara Espy and her mother walked from Spokane, Washington to New York City to earn a wager of $10,000 from the fashion industry, enough to save the family farm from foreclosure. The women wore the new reform dress, risky apparel in 1896, when modesty meant ankles were covered and corsets worn daily. It was a time when women could enroll in Cambridge University, but couldn't receive a degree. When people feared women might die of brain sickness going on to higher education. Unemployment soared, wages sank. It was a time of economic and social unrest. Yet these two women walked across the country following the railroad, earning their keep by washing laundry in the fine hotels along the way. They sold photographs of themselves to commemorate their bold adventure. Clara saw her mother in a new light, learned family secrets, yet struggled with her fear that the entire journey was a foolish adventure.
We arrived in New York City in December, but we were 2 weeks late. I'd sprained my ankle and the sponsors wouldn't extend our time. They reneged, wouldn't pay us. The trip had been for nothing.
Betrayal and grief were their traveling companions on the return trip, and they faced more tragedy at home. Then Clara took a different path. She changed her name and separated herself from her Norwegian-American family for more than 20 years. In her exile, what did Clara learn about family, forgiveness, and reconciliation? Did she ever discover the true gift that is A Daughter's Walk? The Daughter's Walk is a family saga covering 40 years, weaving a fabric of personal history and fiction. It invites readers to consider their own journeys of family schisms and separations, to move us out of exile, to discover what love and grace are truly all about on the walk that takes us home.